What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. It is your girl Bree. If you guys are new here, that is me. Thank you guys so much for watching today. Today we'll be talking about adult braces. The number one thing I would say you need to know about getting adult braces is patience. It's not gonna happen overnight. Your teeth are not gonna be straight in the top of a finger. You're gonna have to wait probably anywhere between 12 months to 24 months to more if your teeth really need work. So I was thinking that I was only going to be my braces for about 6 months because I only wanted to close my gap. However, my orthodontist did tell me that I had some other issues, and that's another thing I want to talk about is they're going to find other things wrong with your teeth. I mean, that's their job at the end of the day. I didn't know I had an overbite. I talked about that a little bit in my last video. I didn't even know I had a severe overbite, but apparently that's something that needs to be corrected. So another thing I want to tell you guys is it does hurt. You guys would think that only children say it hurt, but actually as an adult it does hurt, especially when you're closing gaps. Your teeth are actually moving, so you're gonna have some pain, especially when you get these things called power chains. We'll talk about that in a later video. But power chains hurt, and I can tell you that from experience. I've been in my braces now for about 7 months, and I've had just regular elastics around my brackets, and I've also had power chains, and the power chains hurt the most. I want to talk about the colors of the bands that you put on your teeth. Well, number one, let me back up. Number one, I had a video about why I didn't get Invisalign, because as an adult, you don't necessarily want people to be able to know that you have braces or to see that you're trying to correct your teeth at such a late age. But when you have Invisalign, guess what? People can see them. And if you guys haven't noticed, I have ceramic braces on the top, and guess what? I know you can see them. So if I were you, I would just go ahead and go with the metal, because either way, people are going to be able to see them. You know, if you want a more discreet look, I guess you could go with the ceramics like I did. And luckily, at my orthodontist, it didn't cost more. At some orthodontists, it does cost more. Mine did not. And also on the bottom teeth, they had to put metal brackets because the size of my teeth, they're small on the bottom, so they couldn't put ceramics on the bottom, which ceramics are a little more bulkier than the traditional metal braces, which... Now I wish I would have gotten metal on the top and bottom. It would have been so much easier for me. It just would have looked better in contrast. But I'm happy with what I have. But if I could start over, I would just go ahead and get metal on the top and bottom. So when you're choosing your rubber band colors, girl, do not get white rubber bands. Do not get white elastics on your teeth, on your brackets. Guys, they turn yellow. They're going to make your teeth look yellow. If the orthodontist tells you, oh, get pearl, it's like an off-white, don't get those either. They turn yellow. If you drink coffee, if you eat a little curry chicken like I do it. Don't get yellow. Don't get white. Don't get off-white. Don't get pearl. And definitely don't get clear. All those are going to turn your teeth or turn the bands yellow, therefore making your teeth look yellow. You don't want that. So the color that I have opted to go with more recently is silver. Silver, actually, you can see the silver elastics, of course, because you can see any other color. But they don't stain the same way as the white, clear, or pearl elastics do. And my ortho recommended that I get black, even though I do have ceramics at the top. So I think next time I go on, my next appointment is June 4th. I think I'm going to go ahead and try the black elastics because he said now that I don't really care that people can see them, because I know they can see them anyway, that the black makes your teeth look the whitest and they don't stain because they're black. So I think next time I'm going to go ahead and try the black out. So you know how growing up people say, okay, when you have braces, you can't eat candy, you can't chew gum, you can't eat hard things, you can't eat popcorn. Well, guess what? I do all of those, okay? I've been chewing gum religiously since I was probably 14 years old. I chew gum every day. My braces are not falling out. The brackets have not broken due to me chewing gum. And I chew sugar-free gum, so that's probably a plus. But they don't want you eating candy or chewing gum, but that's what I do anyway, and mine are just fine. But just keep in mind, if you do eat hard things like hot wings like me, I'll eat some hot wings, and I did break a bracket. So guys, just be mindful of that. When you're eating those wings, just tear it off with your hand. Don't be like me and break a bracket. I've only broken one bracket so far, and like I said, it's been 7 months. One bracket, I don't think that's too bad. I was just eating some little hot wings and got a little carried away putting the hot wing in my mouth. So Don't be like me, guys. Just, you know, you can chew your gum. And I'm not a dentist, not an orthodontist. I'm just telling you what I've experienced. I've chewed my gum, and no harm came to me. No harm came to me, and I do chew sugar-free gum. You want to make sure you do your research on different orthodontists, because even several different orthodontists in your area are going to charge different amounts of money. I found the orthodontist that was going to charge me $7,000 for my treatment for the ceramic braces. The ortho I have now, great orthodontist, only charges me $3,500. That's a big difference. $7,000, $3,500. That's a great difference. So you guys, just keep in mind, you got to do your research, look at reviews. When you go to the dental office, you're going to be able to get a consultation. Usually those are free, maybe $25. I think I went on 4 consultations before I chose the orthodontist that I went with. I ended up going with the second one. So you want to get a feel for the doctor, talk to the doctor, ask them how long they think you'll be in treatment. So most of the orthodontists all told me around the same amount of time, anywhere between 18 to 24 months for me. And I went with the best doctor I could find, great reviews. The cost was a little lower than some of the other ones I tried. And remember, the cheapest isn't always the best. So that's why I said just do your research, go to different orthodontists, and, you know, get some consultations done, actually get to know the doctor, so you'll see, you know, if you'll like that doctor or not. Keep in mind of the distance of where you live to where your orthodontist is, because guess what? If you break a bracket, and let's just say you just got your new elastics on, you just got your braces tightened, and you broke a bracket. So you're going to want to go ahead and get that bracket replaced, because if you don't, you're setting yourself back. You're going to have to be your braces longer if you don't get that bracket fixed, because that tooth is not going to be adhering the way it should. So you need to go ahead and get that bracket fixed. So let's say you're breaking brackets often. You want to make sure you live a distance to your orthodontist that you feel comfortable going to at any time. You know, you can call for an emergency if you break a bracket. But if you're close, my ortho told me if I'm within a week away from my next appointment and I break a bracket, don't even worry about it. Just come in that week's appointment. But let's just say you're 4 weeks from an appointment and you broke a bracket, you want to go ahead and get it taken care of. So just keep in mind the distance that you live away from your orthodontist. And the last thing, guys, I want to mention is people are going to ask you, why did you get braces? You're grown. You know, you didn't need braces. You know, don't worry about what anyone else says. Do it for you. Do it because you want your teeth correct. People are always going to say there was nothing wrong with your teeth. Oh, I lift your gap, blah, 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 blah. No. Do what you want to do. And like I said, I like my braces. I think they're cute. So, you know, it is what it is. So, yeah, guys. So, people are going to constantly ask you about your braces. Ask you, you know, oh, why'd you get braces? Or, you know, you're too old to have braces. Just ignore that. We're not too old to have braces. You can get your braces in your adult life if you weren't lucky enough to get them in your childhood. All right, guys. So, that's it about adult braces. I'll come to you guys with the update when after my next appointment and show you what those black elastics look like. In this video, I'm going to give you a couple of pictures to show you where I started the first day getting braces, toward the middle, and now. I'm going to give you some close-up pictures so you guys can see what they look like. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Bree. Make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know when I post a new video, and like my video and share it and leave me a comment. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.